Hey guys, welcome to another episode in the playthrough of Dark Souls 3. I am continuing with trying to get good against Millwood Knights. I need to take three out in a row. First one I have pretty much down. I do aerial attack on him and then three parries and a light attack. Then the second one I have not beaten yet. And I will not be able to do an aerial attack on him, so I wonder how did he hit me? I wonder whether I can. Ah, damn it, I'm missing all my parries over here. If I would have won that one, I wouldn't have deserved it. That was really all mistakes on my part. But I wonder the second one, I cannot aerial attack him, so whether also three parries and a regular attack suffices for him, or whether I will need to do four parries for him. I have no idea. I do know I've been at this for quite a long time already. Quite annoying, but yeah, that's Dark Souls. And again, totally missing my berry. My bad. And again, what's up with me? I had this guy in the previous episode, like 3-4 times in a row at the start of each episode, no problem. And now I went and made some tea and now my timings are totally off suddenly. That's really what I notice. If this game, if you're really into it, unfortunately I have like a super annoying job, so I don't have that much time nowadays. But if you're fully into it, you do get good. You have like the parry timings, it's more like muscle memory. You just have to get into the flow, and that takes time. You cannot just play once every week and then expect to immediately be good again, or at least I cannot do that. Totally missed that one. Well, that is one of the easier ones to parry. Just like that one. Alright. I don't know what's going on with me. I more or less recognize their attacks, but my index finger, it is just randomly pressing the left trigger to parry. Missing them all. Anyways, maybe other people can do it, but I really need to be in a zone that I get good. And once I return after a week or so, it takes some time to get back into that flow. That's not an excuse, it's just fact that I'm just not that instantly good, so to say. Oh. Right now I'm really almost like, you know what, I'm just gonna gonna stop. I don't even deserve to win this if I'm playing this fucking bad. Fuck me. This guy as well. Gets me. Just kill me. Just kill me already. Just kill me already. Fuck me so hard. Limitless stamina. It is so annoying. Those enemies. Continuing to swing. Once you're staggered, he follows up with four others. I could have rolled away probably, but I'm just like, okay, I'm not even gonna bother. This is so frustrating. It also means like having to spend like three Estus flasks to even get to the Millwood Knights. Half the amount of damage that I already took from this guy. But it's so annoying waiting over here for him turn around. He is so slow, it's all so annoying. This local mechanic. Three parries. Now light attack. Yes. Right, now for the next dude. Charged attack of him is so annoying. When he turns red for a long time. It's not like one or two high energy attacks. It really lasts for like 15 seconds. And I'm not sure, maybe you can parry him through that face. I don't want to try, because that's also the problem with enemies like these. Because it takes so much time to even get to them, you play more cautious than you would otherwise do. shards anymore. I'm only getting gems. I'm not really sure I'm happy with that. In the open, even if I have to deal with that earthquake crap. Was a miss parry at least. It was a miss parry, but I could still in time roll away. But after that, he did that very slow ground and pound, and I parried too early. Or, no, I did. He did hit me. I blocked it, but then it took away all my stamina for to do anything follow up. Before he hit again. At least that's what I think happens. Didn't even see that attack from him yet, or at least I don't remember. It was a really weird overhead under swing. This guy, man. Can it be any more annoying, this game? But huds. That took two Estus. And now for this annoying dude. Here we go. Sure why, because I'm just too panicky and I think, all right, I will just get two or three more parries in a row, but I shouldn't. The problem is, accessing up, I want to get out of the aggro zone, but I think the further you get out of the zone, he will start doing his red supercharge attack. At least that's what I think now is happening. That if you stay close, that you have a better chance of avoiding that attack. But yeah, anyways, doesn't matter. I just need to escape. To damage. Hard to distinguish those attacks. I parried too early because I thought he was already going to swing forward, but this is, I think, was his very slow ground pound, so he was still in the process of stretching out backwards before starting the swing. But yeah, I was like, this is that other attack, I will already parry now. But that was the wrong decision. Just all very, very annoying. Here, that was, I think, that same very slow attack. Now I buried him at the right time. Thank you. He did get 400 of my health, goddammit. Something I've read somewhere. I think that third guy is not the same as the first guy that I'm now pretty well consistent against. I think once I get close to the third guy, he will also get a shield and an axe. I'm not 100% sure, but pretty sure. That means I actually, it's more important for me to get better with the second guy than the first guy. Because the third guy will be the same as the second guy. I have to face that moveset with the axe and the shield twice. First I thought that the third guy was the same as this guy. Because they have similar weapons. Anxious, impatient, better to keep a bit of distance, maybe in between parries, reset a bit. On the other end, it doesn't really matter, you just have to recognize the attacks, and if you do, you can just as well stay close and be done with it quicker. The longer the fight lags on, drags on, the bigger the chance you will make a mistake and die anyway. So for both, there's something to be said. Stay close, do it quick. Or keep distance, reset, and maybe a bit safer. Also, a longer fight. Here, this lock on the camera. Holy shit, that was a close call. Luckily, I rolled out of the way. That's pretty fine. His attacks are sometimes... Yeah. Probably I should be less eager now getting past this guy, because this is taking overall more time than just being more systemic in the fight itself. By keeping a bit of distance at least. Not doing so makes for a quicker fight, but if you then also die a lot more, this whole run towards it is a lot of time in itself that is wasted. Oh. Health he takes. Alright, I'm just gonna continue, but yeah, and it's 3:30. My Estus flask. Smooth, but I did lose quite a bit of Estus. And I'm going to be again liberal with my Estus. I'm gonna try and phrase a bit better, probably a bit less commentary, because I cannot take him out if he falls down. It's so annoying, man. It's so annoying. Guy turns around and spots you or not, and then you still have to deal with three Millwood Knights and then that guy in front of it. It's just really a troll placement, that enemy. Just to troll players. Like, yeah, you want to fight three Millwood Knights, but also has to deal with this fucking annoying follower that once in a while spots you. Just so annoying. I mean, he isn't even hard, but I don't even want to spend energy on that guy. If I have to deal with three of these guys. Thinking, man. don't want to be in that little cordoned off area. I want to be more. It doesn't matter, anyways. The problem is with those earthquakes. If you want to heal, healing from that Millwood Knight is not such a big issue. But the problem is, once you get away from the Millwood Knight, it could very well be that you're just in the middle of some earthquake zone. Which then gets you anyways while you're healing. This was not one of the big attacks. It was. I think I was hit there. I'm not sure. I wonder, by the way, whether this guy regenerates. Try to. Yes. Even though the parish had quite a long time in between them, I could still finish him up with a light attack. So probably he doesn't. Super attacks, it really lasts like 20 seconds, or maybe even longer. I mean, pretty sure I cannot really parry through his thrust attacks when he is fully charged and glowing red. I'm not even gonna try that. I just want to get through that phase and then get his regular attacks again. Alright, not too shabby. I got two in. Alright, you know. I know, I wanted to say I'm just gonna start over. Check out how much time this costs. Just so incredibly frustrating. Ooh, I forgot that ground. Holy shit, that was a close one. Parries on him, and I think he needs more than four parries, goddammit. And he is regenning health, it's so annoying. Anyways, that was by far my best try yet. Maybe I should play with HUD because then I know maybe I could have taken him with a regular attack. And the parry wasn't even necessary. Oh man, check out how that guy closes the distance. This is so frustrating, I just don't want to be in the same universe as that guy. probably should play with the HUD on. Shall I? I will do it on just to learn the other guys how much damage I'm doing. I really hate this HUD, but sometimes recognizing that third attack. Check out how big that part in the bottom left of the screen is. I mean, how retarded do you have to need such a big HUD? It's all so retarded, man, nowadays. This is already an older game, but nowadays it's even worse than it was back then. At least From Software gives you the option to turn it off. But the whole dumbing down of everything in society, it's pretty annoying. It was nearly successful, I think, but nearly is not. So it doesn't matter. Didn't recognize the ground explosion. I was about to roll away from his second attack, but there wasn't no second attack because it was the ground explosion. I mix it up with that. I think he has like sometimes a double overhead attack as well, which starts pretty much similar to the ground explosion attack. I wonder how much damage I do, by the way. Let's check that out. Motherfucker. this guy takes way less damage, I think. Or maybe the same damage, but he is health regenning. I don't think, if I saw what was of his total health pool, what I took off, I need to do that. The marker. I will be ending the episode here. We'll continue in the next one. Guys, hope you enjoyed. Hope to see you there. For the meantime, don't forget, always do keep on gaming. See you later.